Hi, Julie and other Ohio teachers. This is Kim from Studies Weekly, and I just want to show you what's available on our online teacher account. So you can go to studiesweekly.com/online, and you're going to log in. You can use our demo account, OH Teacher, Ohio Teacher, and the password is demo, D-E-M-O. Go ahead and log in. We're going to go through this rather quickly. It's just to let you know what's available on your teacher resource tab, and I'm going to give you some idea of what's coming to Ohio Teacher online accounts very soon. So let's go ahead and take a look at the reading tab. On the reading tab, you're going to be able to see all of our publications available for Ohio's teachers and students. And for the purpose of this little video tour, we're just going to stop at third grade, Ohio Community Studies Weekly. You can click on that. This is the student edition. You can use it on your whiteboard if you have an interactive Promethean board or something. Everything is functional. 100% of our online components work with whatever technology you happen to have, including smartphones, tablets, that sort of thing. And you do not need to have Flash in order to use our student editions. So here you can see we have all of our weekly units available. And we're going to click on week one. We use the word week and unit interchangeably. And within week one, we have the following articles. So we'll click on the Welcome to Ohio Community Studies Weekly. 100% of our publications have the read aloud feature. Okay, and I don't have my sound on. We can also take a look at physical and political maps. We have lots of great articles. Just to give you an idea of what it looks like. So you can check out all of our offerings on the reading tab. We have our online test setup. This is a great tool for teachers to use in the classroom and also in the computer lab. I'm going to scroll down to Second Grade Studies Weekly. If it's red, it's off. If it's green, it's on and available for your students to take online. Here's how you open the test. What I like about this is you're using our bank of test questions. These are exact same ones that are on your teacher resource book. However, you have the option of editing or deleting our questions. You can also add as many new questions as you want. Multiple choice, true, false, open-ended, check all that apply, or fill in the blank. And the computer will score all of these except for the open response, which you would have to do. It automatically scores. It allows your students to have multiple attempts if you allow it. You can also view the test, print the test. You can adjust the score. You can export it into an Excel spreadsheet or a Google Docs Sheets, and you can also print it out. Your ungraded questions, these are the ones that you've put in that are open response. There would be a text box for you to respond to each child's individual answer and award points. For class admin, this is how you set up your classes, and we'd give you more of a tutorial on this. However, you can set up multiple classes, so in case you have a morning class and an afternoon class, you can add classrooms and assign them each their own publication. So if you have a 2-3 level split, you certainly can do that, and then you'll assign the publication. You can add parent emails on here. Send class a message, which is a nice feature. So we have lots of goodies on here. The resource tab, this is really where it's at. Now, because this is our demo account, not everything is 100% functional, but if you had some questions and you wanted more information, you can always reach out to us, studiesweekly.com, and there's a contact us, or you can contact me directly. Here's where we have all of our publications, and we're going to go to fourth grade, Ohio Studies Weekly. We're going to click that. We have our standards correlation document here. So it lets you know where everything is. Nice little feature. We have our student editions and our teacher supplements. And you can view all of these 100%. So this is a flex page. It takes a couple seconds to load. And you can zoom in, you can get as close as you want. And we can flip pages and go through the entire document. You can do the same thing with the teacher editions, the teacher supplements. And further down, we have our general resources. Our opening video, Bring History to Life lesson plans. These are grade specific and period specific. We have our general resources, our digital developments. This is a list of 2.0 technologies that we're encouraging teachers to do in a shared or modeled setting. All of these are free. You can flip through. It's a 20-page PDF, and we also tell you our examples of how we've used it in the classroom. Everything has been tested on real kids who don't follow directions. We also have our poster lesson plans because those come at the beginning of the year in grades 3 through 6. We don't want it to turn out to be wallpaper. We want you guys to actually use it. So we have lesson plans and enrichment activities for all 8 posters. We also have our wraps, our primary source analysis tool, Cornell note-taking method, tons of stuff. And I know you guys are Gmail compatible, so maybe you want to check out our Google search quick tips for kids. I used this with a third grade class this past year. It worked out really well. They were very successful, and I'll be posting a video sometime later on this year of how that lesson went. So it's a great way to teach your kids to do a more productive online search. We have a couple other goodies in here. In our miscellaneous, again, you're going to have more PDFs that you can download. If you want to do debate carousels, here's the PDF. We recommend the reciprocal teaching method. We call it the Fab Four, and so on. Studies Weekly Display Tray. This is an actual activity along with a mini lesson plan that can be used for all grade levels, ESE, ELL, 504 kids. It's a great activity. So there's the template. There's a note to the teacher, and here's a finished student example there. Just to give you an idea of what we have online. We have our professional development on demand. If you have new teachers to your district, your school, or to the profession, here's a great way to give them professional development in 10 minutes or less. They can do it on their own time, and it's a great way to bring them up to speed, especially if they don't have a lot of experience. These are all research-based strategies, and we have even more on YouTube. We have 2 channels. Please visit us, YouTube, Studies Weekly, and subscribe to our channel. We also have virtual field trips, a whole lot more than it's just listed right here. That's a great way to build student background knowledge and help them make connections to whatever you're reading and experiencing in class. And then we have our leveled readers. We have 72 titles per grade level, and these are downloadable. And all teachers have access to these, not just K1 and 2. And they go along with our Studies Weekly Social Studies newspapers. I'm going to scroll up to the top. The last one is our media search button. If you wanted to discuss a topic like maps with your class, you can click and select only videos, only audio, or only pictures. But if you uncheck them, they'll search for everything. You click, and then you're going to see all of the cool resources. These are all produced in-house, so you're not going to have to worry about content or comments that you might have when you're going online. So you would have to preview these to make sure they're appropriate for your grade level, but you won't have to worry about any inappropriate content or comments. So you just keep loading more until it didn't load anymore. So we have tons of really cool things for you already. However, I'm going to sign out of Ohio Teacher and go into Texas Teacher. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I want to show you what's coming soon to Ohio. So this is our Texas, and I'm going to click on reading. I'm going to scroll down to third grade Texas Community Studies Weekly, and I'm going to click on the week 1. Notice the red icon. It's a mortarboard like the kind you wear for graduation. As that pops out, you're going to have an introductory video. This is me introducing the lesson and letting the teacher know in 30 to 60 seconds what should you be sure to cover? What kind of research-based strategies? Are there any black line masters or must-have activities that you cover? So it's a super short video. It's a great way to get a handle on the week's worth of content. Okay, and I still have the sound off. All right. You'll also see all of your unit standards, any professional development videos that are important to that week. Your lesson plans will be included there. Now you can go online and check this out a lot slower. I know I'm speeding through it. So if you go into our studiesweekly.com/online and you log in with TX teacher and then demo as the password, you'll be able to access all of this. So we have lots and lots of great information, and this is coming to Ohio as well. So we have the PDFs that are available in the teacher resource book, but at point of use, so you can just print them out as you need them. So that's just one of the great features we have, and you click the red box to close it. So you want to go to the weekly unit level, click on week one, click on the red hat box, it pops out, click it to close it, and you can go back to the reading. And so we have lots of great things for you online. I hope you take the time to check it out. I know you guys are all busy. If you have any questions or concerns, you can always reach out to Studies Weekly. Thank you so much.